Hey, everybody, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. It's me, Casey, talking today about Lattice Semiconductor, one of my favorite semiconductor companies. And today we're going to focus on how this small chip company is eating Intel and AMD's market share. Let's first start by just doing a brief recap on what Lattice does. Lattice Semiconductor is an FPGA pure play. FPGAs, or field programmable gate arrays, are a type of flexible semiconductor. They contain configurable building blocks connected by reprogrammable wiring. Now, this is unique because it allows designers to change the FPGA's function with software even after it's been manufactured. So this makes them different from ASICs, application-specific integrated circuits, which are designed for a single unchangeable purpose. Now, on the screen, you'll see a number of applications that Lattice's FPGA chips are used in. You can see communications, computing, industrial, automotive, consumer, lots of industries, but we're going to focus on a couple of these parts of the industry today and how that has been affecting Lattice Semiconductor, especially in their most recent earnings report. And just a quick, fun little fact, you may recall in our last video of Lattice Semiconductor, we pointed out the use of a Lattice chip in the Apple Vision Pro. Thanks to iFixit.com, they broke down that Vision Pro when it first came out, and you can see there in orange the Lattice Semiconductor ICE40 Ultra FPGA. Okay, let's talk about Lattice Semiconductor's high-level numbers for Q1 2024. They just reported this last week. Revenue was $140.8 million, which is down nearly 24% year over year and down 17.5% quarter over quarter. Their GAAP gross margin, 68.3%. It was 69, nearly 70% same time last year. On a non-GAAP basis, gross margin was 69%. On a GAAP basis, net income of 11 cents per share. And on a non-GAAP basis, net income, 29 cents per share. You can see that's down 43% year over year. Lattice's earnings report came in right on target with their predictions. While the predictions and results were not pretty, there really weren't any surprises. You can see that in this chart here that they provided as well. And then we'll just briefly go back to this one and take a look at the center there in the end market overview. The automotive market segment for Lattice reported a 31% year-over-year decline, and comms, which is the communication infrastructure, you can think of that as 5G base stations, and computing was down 18% year-over-year. Automotive decline was primarily due to that weakness in demand and inventory drawdown. We talked about this in their last earnings report as well. And as we reported last autumn, after 2 years of epic auto sales due to the chip shortage, automakers have now flipped to fretting over too much inventory. Now, this has also been in part hastened by softer consumer spending on autos due to those higher interest rates. They also saw a decline in demand for telecom infrastructure. This was particularly during the last 1 to 2 months of Q1 and into Q2. This is tied to reduced telecom carrier CapEx spending on property and equipment. Improved spending by some of those larger telecom carriers on infrastructure will drive demand for telecom equipment, which will ultimately benefit Lattice. So we can watch the CapEx spend of some of those companies. And when that CapEx starts to climb, we can expect an uptick for Lattice, perhaps in 2025. This is a similar negative effect reported by other fabless chip companies like Marvell Technology Group. But in contrast to communications and automotive, Lattice's compute sector performed well in Q1, driven by server sales, both general purpose and AI-optimized servers. And management said that compute is expected to grow into Q2 and has now become the larger segment when compared to communications. Ultimately, even with this 24% year-over-year decrease in overall revenue, this performance is notably better than major competitors like Intel's Altera, which it reorganized under the name it acquired back in 2015, as it plans to re-IPO the business for cash, similar to what they did with Mobileye, and also with AMD's embedded division. And that was created after the Xilinx acquisition in 2022. Just for reference, Intel's Altera revenue was down 58% year over year, and AMD's embedded down 46% year over year. So in other words, Lattice is picking up FPGA market share. Okay, let's talk about the competition for Lattice. Lattice feels very confident that it has a competitive position within the FPGA market. Their Nexus line of small FPGAs, which you can see on the bottom of this infographic, offers strong power efficiency, and their new mid-range Avant products are demonstrating some clear differentiation. You can see those on the top of this infographic. They've seen share gains in small FPGAs and aim for further growth across both small and mid-range segments. AMD's embedded has moved away from low-end FPGAs, and that has opened up some opportunities for Lattice, and they are definitely hoping to capitalize on that move from AMD. As we talked about last year and early in 2024, when we called Lattice a favorite chip stock during this cyclical downturn, big mergers like AMD's of Xilinx often means a pullback in product lines in the name of boosting profit margins, which opens the door for smaller competitors like Lattice. CEO Jim Anderson was asked about Intel's reallocation of capital with Altera and the probable IPO in the future. And he said that Lattice has gained significant share over the past year, and they continue to see opportunity to grow and gain share in small FPGAs. Also, they're at the beginning of the Avant revenue ramp up, and they believe that they can significantly grow that over the coming years. He also makes a point that Avant uses all the same software as Nexus, so it leverages the same development software, the same solutions. And when they look at the target customers for Avant, 90% of the target customers for Avant are already customers of Lattice. This fact that Avant shares software with Nexus simplifies adoption, and the existing customer base sees it as a natural extension, which further strengthens Lattice's position. And customers also would appreciate Lattice's commitment to sustained innovation and long-term support, which makes them a preferred supplier in small and mid-range FPGA solutions. We can see that management seems to think they have reached the bottom. They expect that Q2 revenue will decline a bit further due to the weaker demand and inventory adjustments, especially in the communications sector. But they do anticipate revenue growth in the second half of 2024, driven by improved market conditions and the ramp up of their new Nexus and Avant products. Anderson says that it's not going to be a light switch where it just turns on, but rather the drawdown of inventory will start to dissipate through the second half of the year. And they definitely believe that the second half revenue will be stronger than the first half. Let's talk about our final takeaways from this earnings call. We really like that management has invested in their own stock during this downturn. CFO Sherry Luther said that they repurchased approximately 265,000 shares, or $20 million worth of stock, making it the 14th consecutive quarter of share buybacks. Over that period of time, they've repurchased about 5 million shares, reducing the dilution by 3.6%. Lattice is currently experiencing a downturn along with the broader auto and industrial focus market. We remain confident in their long-term prospects here at Chipstock Investor. The company has definitely demonstrated resilience and has navigated these challenges very effectively. We anticipate a future upswing as automotive and industrial sectors work through their inventory adjustments and return to normalcy. At this time, we are holding steady with our existing position in Lattice. We added a small amount to our holdings earlier this year and believe our current stake is well positioned to benefit from the company's future growth, especially in the second half of 2024. Okay, that's a wrap on this episode. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you have not already. If you want to find our video notes, you can check those out on ko-fi.com. If you're interested in our Semiconductor Insider membership, check out our join page here on YouTube or over on our Ko-fi channel. That subscription service gets you access to our Discord channel where we post all of our notes, as well as great discussion on stocks and all things semiconductor. Everyone have a great weekend. We will see you again soon here at Chipstock Investor.